Good morning, Southwest Florida. I'm Carly Bradley. This Naples Herald morning report is sponsored by Conditioned Air, the comfort people since 1962. This morning, we'll tell you about a glitch for Netflix employees, the new FGCU president, and more. Today is Tuesday, March 1st, and this is the morning report. The search for a replacement for departing President Dr. Wilson Bradshaw has not been an effortless or straightforward adventure for the Florida Gulf Coast Board of Trustees. Nevertheless, today the board has selected Dr. Michael Martin as the school's next president. Martin has experience in the Florida university system, having served as the vice president for agriculture and natural resources at the University of Florida from 1998 to 2004. During Martin's time at New Mexico State University, he completed a campus master plan, launched their first capital campaign, and launched a research and development park. To read more about Dr. Martin, visit leeherald.com. Florida lawmakers are poised to return to Tallahassee for the March 7th start of the 2017 legislative session. They will grapple with hundreds of bills during the 60-day session, while also trying to reach agreement on a state budget that will top $80 billion. The Naples Herald staff has come up with a top 10 list of big issues to watch, including the death penalty, guns, medical marijuana, and more. To read the full list, visit naplesherald.com. Netflix employees were personally affected by U.S. President Donald Trump's attempt to ban people entering from seven Muslim countries, the company's CEO said on Tuesday. Reed Hastings has been a critic of the temporary travel ban, which Trump hopes to revive in a revised form this week, and told the Associated Press on Tuesday that some of his coworkers had gotten caught up in it. Netflix was among dozens of tech companies that publicly opposed the travel ban out of fear that it would stifle innovation. To read the rest of the story, visit naplesherald.com. And that was the morning report for today. I'm Carly Bradley. The morning report airs Monday through Friday right here at naplesherald.com. And don't forget to check out our lunch break that also airs Monday through Friday at 12 p.m. Thank you for watching and have a great rest of your day.